G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. I was just surfing the internet the other day, and I think I was looking at Wingnut Wings planes or something like that because of the whole closing down thing. And as you do, you get on these tangents on the internet where, you know, they'll pop up sort of images of things. And for some strange reason, I came across this. As soon as I saw it, I thought, I've got to pick this up. It just, this to me, regardless of whatever it's supposed to be, it just reminded me of a bat plane. I thought, this looks like Batman, sort of what a Batman plane should look like. So I absolutely just fell in love with it before I sort of worked out, you know, the whole ins and outs of, you know, this attempt at a sort of a Russian stealth plane, and which never really existed. But when I saw it, I thought, this, you know, this is almost sci-fi to me. I mean, I think it looks absolutely fantastic. Here's the back of it here. Hopefully you might be able to read a little bit of the instructions there. Hopefully you can read the model kit features there. But I just looked at this and I just thought, this looks absolutely fantastic. I mean, it sort of reminds me of what is it? One of the Avengers, even the Avengers plane. But with it all into that matte black sort of look, it just looks fantastic to me. I don't know if I'd even use the decals that come with it. And obviously this is an old kit. I think it was around 1987 or something like that. It could even be a bit later, earlier. But around that era, in the 80s. There we have. We've got 1987 down there. So, I just had to pick it up, guys. I just absolutely love the look of it. I'll have a quick look inside at the instructions, as we do. Still all sealed. You've got to love that. Some of these old kits, as you do with some of these older kits, they have the things falling off the parts already. And I'll tell you what, one of my pet hates is when they don't put the cockpit thing in a sealed glass thing. Really, really bugs me that they don't put that in a separate bag, because it obviously gets all scratched and everything like that, which does bother me quite a bit. Not much in this kit. I love going through these old kits. There's something about it, guys. That's why I like doing these videos. Just stuff that, you know, maybe you don't see in the shops anymore and it's hard to find. And I just absolutely love doing videos on this sort of stuff. It's like, YouTube's like the new encyclopedia, if you like, where you can get on and actually, you know, and not just read about things, but actually view things, which I think is absolutely the fantastic thing about YouTube. You get two sets of decals, well, one set, but two different colours by the looks of it, grey and this sort of reddy maroney colour. I actually really like this sort of, I don't know, I call it maroon, but it's absolutely, I quite like the writing on it and everything like that. Looks like it's all in Russian. I love going through these old sort of catalogues. Testers have done so many different things. I mean, I've got some, is it resin figures? The old resin figures I've shown in the past by testers. And they were like about, what, 1/8 scale, 1/9 scale. So they've dipped their toes in quite a number of things. Here's your first page. Even there, I just love the look of this thing. It looks fantastic. You gotta love these old kits. I mean, look at this, just two sprues. This is going to be a pretty quick build. Obviously, there's going to be a lot of gap filling and stuff to do, but I mean, as far as assembly wise, apart from the gap filling and seam filling, it's going to be a very quick kit to put together. Little cockpit there, and again, I'm going to have to work out whether I'm going to put this. I'll try and find a little Batman figure, to go in there. I might even have to sculpt my own, or try and find one out of a micro machine set or something like that to sit in there. They get pretty basic instructions. You have the canopy in an open and closed position. Mine will be closed. And just this side here. It's looking pretty simple kit. Doesn't this look like the, I don't know what the name of it is, guys. Someone could comment on it. Oh, the Avengers, you know, their plane, whatever it's called. That, from the top down, that's what it looks like to me. I would be surprised if they've stolen the design from this, because that's what it reminded me of straight away. It's not looking too bad. A couple of minor scratches along there. Hopefully we might be able to buff those out a bit. Put a bit of a future or whatever else on there. Clean it up a little bit. But I really wish they would, I mean, I know we're going back to the 1980s, guys, but I really wish they'd put these sort of things in separate bags. Stop them from getting scratched. That would be the nice thing to do. And we'll just measure this up a little bit. And that is looking to be roughly around 250 mil, or 25 centimeters if you like. I just love the color of this thing. It just looks awesome. Might just whack this on here for a bit of fun. Where's this go at the back here, does it? Somewhere like this. There we go. Nice. It's got the raised panel lines. A couple of funny marks at the back here. I don't know if they're supposed to be there. It's pretty interesting sort of marks along there. Can't see that sort of anywhere else. There's not many parts, but you know, the detail on the parts isn't too bad. It's a little bit soft, but especially around here, it's a bit thick and clunky. Again, here you've got some, hopefully it'll show up, some interesting sort of, I don't know what you'd call it. Looks like something's gone a bit cuckoo in the moulding process. You can't, it's not raised or anything, you can't feel it. You can just sort of see it. And on this side too. Well, that is a bit raised there, along that panel there. I don't know if it'll show up. There's a little bit of a lip there. I don't know if that's supposed to be there or not. Here you have the pilot seat. It's not too much detail there. Just a little bit of detail there, not much. If you've ever wondered why Tamiya and other brands, they all put their sprues in separate bags sometimes, and you think it's a little bit of overkill. Well, when you look at this kit, you know why. I mean, look at the amount of scratches, guys, on this thing. You know, hopefully they'll show up for you there. It's just so many little scratches along this, just from having two sprues in the one bag, sealed in the box. I mean, but still, look at the amount of scratches on that thing. Mamma mia. I mean, they're very fine. They're not, you know, they're not as though you wouldn't build the kit or anything, but jeez, so many scratches. You don't have to do any weathering on it. It's already done for you. There's a little bit of detail in there. Not much though, but I mean, I'm not going to see that. I'm going to have my plane probably sitting up here flying, so you're not going to be seeing that. I don't think I'm going to even have the wheels down. We've got in there the Testers copyright 1987, so there you go. 1987 it is. Anyway, guys, I absolutely love the look of this, looking at it from front on like this, and I absolutely love the look of it from here. And you actually do get quite a good viewing into the pilot seat, so if you put a decent pilot in there, and here, he's going to show up pretty well. So I'm pretty happy about that. Anyway, as you guys know, I don't do a lot of planes, jets, whatever, but every now and again, as I said, I'm a bit eclectic in my modeling, and if I see something I like and it's just cool looking, I'll pick it up. So this is where that sits. So the MiG-37B Ferret E imaginary stealth plane jet, this is what it looks like. Thanks a lot for watching, guys, and I'll catch you later.